Prêt pour le défi?
And now the match you've all been waiting for. We're about to kick off the AFL Europe 2013 Euro Cup. The one they've all been waiting for. complaints in the mixed wing? This is the one we've all been waiting for. The grand final, the grand finale of the Euro Cup, the Axios Euro Cup 2013. The English versus the old rival, LA Francais. Come on, England. You choose. You choose a winner here. Underway in the final. 20 minutes of the first half. Big punch from Gregoire the Ruckman. France go forward first. 27 slides in. It's a red hot ball early. You can be guaranteed they'll be attacking the ball with vigour and might. As we find our team lists for the game, we have the English versus the French. The French are forward early. Here's the little goal sneak. Has he started with a goal? They're claiming touched. The umpire hasn't seen or heard it. And the little goal sneak, Nicolas Robert, starts with a goal for France to get him underway. How did you like that for a start, Michael?
Oh, I loved it. It's definitely the smaller players from France who are going to dominate this match, if France are to dominate this match, because their small, fast players are the ones that do all the damage. We start again, the umpire throws it up in the middle, and again, the big captain, the big ruckman, Grégoire Patak, takes it out of the ruck, but doesn't get very far until he's wrapped up. Number 10 for France again. Gets it in there. Number 9 for France, Pierre Dandelion, like we've been calling him for the day. Tries to take a big mark, but unfortunately the English defender gets it out of there. The home crowd is right behind this French team. I want them to win desperately. Number 5 for England, Matthew Kilheaney, kicks it into the forward line and finds a target in number 15, Rory Old, lining up for goal now, around about 30 metres out, awkward kicking style, and goes through for a point. So the visitors, one behind, France on one goal, 6 points. Yeah, we're almost at maximum capacity here in the Euro Cup stadium here in Bordeaux. As
on official count, oh, Walton misses to the left. That's the second score on the board for the English. Walton, a star for the English. Mentioning the crowd, we've got official estimates in at around 2,000 through the gate. The grandstand is near capacity. Add on top of that the players, and this is a crackerjack crowd in Bordeaux. 39, one of our favourites, Hotelier Hilton, kicks long. Rory Old cleans up, gets it to the ponytailed man Bickerdike, who kicks long now. Oh, what a pluck from, remind me now, I know the guy, Lee Tan, who has been the forward stalwart for the English the whole competition. He'll be 15 metres out directly in front, should score the goal. He has missed a couple today though. Stuttering start. He just gives it a little clap, 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 like it's a golf putt. But that's 6 points. Bang.
And that puts England 1-2, 8 points, to France 1-straight, 6 points. And the English have definitely come out to play today. France have started off slow. It looks like there's a fair bit of physicality out there. Walton in particular trying to get into the French players, get inside their heads. It's the umpires bring it back to the centre for another throw up in the middle. The ruckman will go at it again and try and tap it forward for their team's advantage. Here we go. England get the tap out. Once more, number nine. For the England drives it forward, and it's a goal! The home crowd are not happy at all about this, but England have their second goal. Two goals, two. To France's one goal straight. 14 plays six here in Bordeaux for the 2013 Euro Cup. This is the championship game, England versus France. If you want to follow AFL Europe on Twitter, at AFL underscore Europe. Go to AFL Europe on Facebook as well for plenty of photos, updates from the day. Beautiful spoil from number six from England.
It was Ian Mitchell. The age will not weary him. Mitch just keeps on going and going. Number five in the ruck is Kilheaney. Slightly out of position for him, the ruckman from Manchester Mosquitoes. Prefers the centre position, but did what he had to in the ruck there. Mitchell applies some pressure on the bottom of the pack, picking himself up slowly for England. That's Paul Francis. Haven't caught a lot of him today. He could be fresh man for the attacking. 71 for France. Emilian Martinez tries to snap, gets blocked. Another snap gets blocked. Great handball release to Kilheaney. Kilheaney kicks long. Our man, Litan, is after it, chasing the Frenchman, Luc Bassard. But the ball beats them both across the line and we'll have a boundary throw-in. Contesting in the ruck will have number 14, Steve Maguire, and the stalwart of the day, Gregoire Patak, for the French. Patak wins the tap, down to 18 for France. We don't have his number, we haven't had it all day. Luke kicks off the ground here. They're fighting over this. Walton on his hands, knees, picks up. Back to the three, again, could be the fresh man. Loic juggles the mark just inside. He's got a free man out wide if he looks. They're all picked up now, so he goes long down the line, very disciplined. Gregoire Patak fights for the ball, drop the mark. Could have been leg there. Mitchell goes hard and the ball beats him out of bounds. Throw it in, thanks.
The umpire on the boundary, nice big throw in. They've got the best umpires for this final match. Speaking about best umpires, Shane Hill plays a free kick for the English team and he's about to kick inside the attacking 25 to Lee Tan. But to no avail. Number 11 for England, Graham Bickerdike. Again, the ponytail clad man kicks it back into the English offensive forward 50. Patak takes it again. Oh, big bump by the Frenchman. That's going to get them fired up. Number 18 again. We haven't known his name all day. But I'm sure we'll learn it after this. And it goes again inside England's forward 25. The Frenchman does very well to get it out of there. And obviously a crowd favourite. Everyone wants him to move it forward. Kicks it again to the opposition. What? The French get it back. And this time they find a target. Every time the French find a target, you'll know about it because the crowd will cheer. They're about to kick it inside the 50. He needs to look for somebody here and find somebody. Look for a big target. Where's Patak? Been dominant all day. Decides to go it alone. Try and kick the goal from about 45 metres out. It's a big, big kick, but it's off target for 1 point.
Attack there with the minor. He's kicked that 50 for the behind. England are bringing in Bickerdike, who's been good all day. Shanks one though. Good enough, England, good enough to clean it up. Puts Loic under pressure. He's mopped up a few already. The backmen are really dominating early here. Hotelier Hilton on centre wing goes short. Great kick. Oh no, he hasn't made it there. Both a little slow to the ball. The mulleted man, Tom Stewart, sweeping across half back. Loic again, he's won about four contests in a row here. He perseveres again. Hotel Hilton cleans up. Kicks it to Dandelion. Dandelion, he's hot, he's hot. Oh, what is that? Holding the ball. Could have probably gone either way with the pushing the back or the holding the ball, but the holding the ball was paid. Rory Olds got the ball here. No, Mark Todd, excuse me. He's about 40 metres out. This one's beyond him for sure. I don't think he can kick the distance. I wouldn't be surprised if it lands short. It does. Loic's there to clean up. Oh. Wow. This guy's played some 10 minutes. He is keeping the Frenchman in it and dominating down back. Nice kick to Gregoire. Gregoire should... No, he drops it. Sean Moulton with a cheeky little spoil there. Gregoire gives a don't argue to Dandelion. Dandelion, spin. There's Emilian. Goes long. Centre forward. Bickerdike. No, he misjudges. Runs underneath the ball. The 88 for France is there. Rory Old picks up. Sean Moulton, steadying hand. Kicks forward to the little goal sneak from the first goal. Oh, he's got rid of it and been dragged down. Free kick paid, well spotted by the umpire. And this is Nicolas Robert who will pump the French forward again.
I think he's also lost a shoe there. No, somebody's lost a shoe and it's just sitting on the field. Flew off in that exchange.
Grass.
Grass? Oh, big divot. It's been told it's grass. But either way, it's a big one. It's deep inside France's forward 50 at the moment. Keep saying forward 50. It's forward 25 here. And France look likely to score a goal here, which would send the crowd wild. Ruckman go up. Number one for France gathers it, but can't get it away, and that'll be holding the ball. And the mulleted man gets it off to number 10 for England, Matt Whiteley. They centre the ball, thinks to play on but chooses wisely not to. The halfbacks are running off for England. Oh, big, big mark. That could be telling. Big mark to the English forward. That would be Maguire. That would be whoever it is. But he kicks and kicks truly, and he has gotten his team another goal.
Show me the money, says Stephen Jerry Maguire. 6 points on the board. We've got the score at 7-20. I don't think there was any talk there to Patak. He could have jumped and spoiled it. He just thought it was an easy mark. And the crowd erupts with an Allez la Bleu. They're trying to fire up their French counterparts. That's probably the first time Loic's been beaten down there forward. The big man, Lee Tan, has got a hold of it. It's been a very good contest forward. Lee Tan from about 25, 45 degree angle. He'll definitely make the distance. And he's kicked truly. That's a good goal to England. And the French just want to be a little bit careful. This game doesn't get away from them early on. 6 minutes left in the first half. And we're now at 19 points of difference. It is only three goals. It's three straight kicks.
We're underway again. The English ruckman gets up and wins the tap. Sean Moulton comes through. And he wins the ball. Great work. but the Frenchman, L'Hotelier, gets it out. Walton goes again. L'Hotelier goes again. The umpire calls throw and he's paid the free kick to England. Controversial decision there. The crowd aren't too happy. Goes in the direction of Lee Tan again. And he's taken it and he snaps around the body and kicks another one. That's Lee Tan's third goal. And England's fifth. England up to 32 points. French have got to be careful that English don't run all over them here. There's just under 5 minutes remaining. As the crowd does the Mexican wave. Just under 5 minutes remaining here. And the English lead 5-32, 32-1, 7. France has desperately got to get another 2 goals before halftime to be in this match and in with a chance of taking home the Euro Cup. France, can they push it forward? They try. It's being held up in the middle. Plenty of clangers there. And the umpire has picked out a free kick to number 15 from England, Gloriol. Plenty of people screaming out for him. He kicks and kicks truly to Mr. Mark Todd. And oh no, what's happened to France? The danger man, Lee Tan, is all by
Tan
himself.
Lines up. He's gone the banana. Just to show his class, his versatility. And he's kicked that. Is that four? Five goals to Lee Tan. Unbelievable start. 5.5 goals. This hasn't been seen since... I don't know if it's been seen. Now it's 6-38 versus 1-1-7. Tan on absolute fire. Even though Loic's been good on him, he finds 5 goals against his counterpart there. The long kick goes forward and that registers a behind for England. Looking very, very strong, maybe a little too strong for the French, but let's not write them off yet. There's another half to turn this around. I'm sure Thomas Urban will give them a real rev up. Hilton Hotelier, we haven't called him much in this game. He's been great all day though. Kicks beautifully out the wing. Number 2, Vautrin, takes the mark. About 45 out, plays on. Well spoiled by Rory Old there. Great spoil and we'll get a throw in. They've got 6-7 around the ball and only 2 forward England. Looks a tactic to me. Ball's cleared. There should be a Frenchman to mop this up, but there's not. Tan doesn't have it. He's tripped accidentally, but tripped nonetheless. Lee Tan. No, you can't play on. Got to come around. Correct call, Shane Hill. I'm not sure that's an advantage, France, because Lee Tan's on fire, and he now lines up for his 6th goal of the half. Now, he hasn't proven to be the longest kick, but he's an accurate kick. At about 40 metres, this might test him. It will test him. Is he up to the task? On fire, you never know. Kicks long and strong and straight. 6 goals. No. Missed to the right-hand side. Not far away. Lee Tan on fire. Someone needs to douse him. Deneuve takes the mark on the half-back flank.
He kicks it long along the wing and I think it's just gone over the boundary line and the umpire will throw it in now with England with a very big lead, 40-7 in the championship match here for the AFL 2013 ASIOS Euro Cup. France get it out. They kick forward. Can they get a mark here? They need something within the last 45 seconds of this half. But England get the clearance through Sean Walton. And again, Walton comes through, takes him on, takes a bounce. Very confident, this man. Kicks it. And the French are back there. They're doing very well in defense. They get it out. It's very good defense there from the French. They're still in this match, and the crowd believe it too. But with only 10 seconds left in this first half, they're going to have to do something very special in the second half to get back and actually win this game. And that's time for the first half. England are leading France. Six goals, four. Oh, wait. Wait for it. I spoke too soon. England get another goal. They finish on 7 goals, 4, 46 to 1 goal, 1, 7. France are in dire trouble here in Bordeaux. Stay tuned for the second half of the 2013 Axios Euro Cup. France go through their halftime rituals and get themselves fired up for the second half. The umpires are calling them in as the second half is about to get underway. The scores here are 7 goals, 4, 46 to 1 goal, 1, 7 in favour of the English as we're about to start this second half and the last half of the Euro Cup in 2013. And here we go. We're underway. Clock is ticking down. Time is ticking away for France to come back and win this. They need a few breaks. They need a few goals. Can they get them? Only time will tell. It's probably the most important 20 minutes of any of these young Frenchmen's football careers so far in their lives. They desperately need a lot of goals, around about 7 goals to get back into this. It's a very unfortunate situation. they could potentially get back into it if they just get the first two or three goals. Very funny game this. Oh, the English mark on the last line of defence and they clear it out. And the ponytail clad man takes it towards the boundary line, finds a player, and ooh, almost a good mark by the Englishman.
That's Ross. My hair is better than Gareth Bale. And he just signals, yes, that's true, Ben McCormack. My hair is better than Gareth Bale's. And he snaps it from the right-hand pocket. It's not a hair out of place on the man that used to work for ESPN, now BT Sport. Loves his football and has a love affair with his hair as well, by the looks. Well done, Ross. The Ruckman go at it again. This game is in danger of fizzling out into just a training run for the English if the French don't pick up their game. It's just a great pressure from the English. Every time a Frenchman grabs the ball, there's a tackler right there with him. They have no space at all. Mitchell's floated forward and said, I wouldn't mind a bit of the action. I'm a backman, but I do not mind the goal. Mitchell runs in, or wanders in more. Kicks long. Oh, it's just stopped on the line. But Lee Tan, with some fancy footwork, goes chip, chip, chip. Goal. There we go. Is that six to Tan? Six, seven goals. Six. We'll go to the official scorer. That's six, he says. Yeah, from the back there. He's called six. Lee Tan with six majors in just over 20 minutes of grand final football. Who knows what's next for Lee Tan? Picks up, snaps, not sure who that was. It's out on the full, the number three, Paul Francis.
And France will bring this back in. They must be a bit deflated at the moment, but they're still going. They're not gonna let this match go. They definitely still think they can win this. The margin is just over 50 points, so it's very highly unlikely that they will actually win, but Lautier has the ball now, and he's the man that you want to get the ball to. Looking for a target, and he finds one. In number one, the French, Alban Shiba. And he has kicked. Kicked a point because it was touched before it went through. Now the scores read France 1-2-8 to England 9-4-58. It's exactly 50 points the difference. And with 15 and a half minutes to go, it doesn't look like there's much chance of France coming back here, unfortunately. And the French crowd are going wild at the minute. I don't think this call has been fair. Number 14 for England has it at the moment, Stephen Maguire. And he's lining up for goal. He runs around, tries to snap it through. And he is successful and has kicked England's 10th goal. England are completely running away with this match. It is England. 10 goals, 4-64 to France. 1 goal, 2-8. The ball is back in the centre. And it does not look like France can get back from here. Umpire throws it up. And Patak goes bang, hits it forward. The Frenchman got dumped down around the neck. He takes his kick. He could line up the goal here, and I think he is going to kick it as far as he can. It's a big kick, and he's got the goal. And everyone in France right now is going crazy. They still think that their team can win.
That's the master organizer of the tournament, Alban Schieber, snapping one through for goal, getting France's second. Puts the tackle on there as well. He's come on like a raging bull, trying to work France back into this. His home tournament, his Bordeaux home turf. And the French, Alban goes again. The emotion of the game. Oh, not happy with the call. Not happy with the call, but I think it's a correct one. He did take him on and then didn't get the handball away. Luke Booth from Huddersfield with his knee heavily bandaged. No longer limping though, so the physio's worked wonders with him. Long drop punts. Great mark. Yeah, it's two hands on it. Who have we got here? Is that number 3, Paul Francis? No. 14, Stevie Jerry Maguire, again, from about 35 out. We're behind this, not directly, but almost. Kicks long, strong, true, great kick for goal. And that's all clear. Made it home by about half a metre, and the English go further in front. Nothing. Ball up there, Rory Old. Ross Myhair's better than Gareth Bale. Smashes that forward and Booth plucks it about a metre out. That was a great kick by Ross Ashman. Hit Luke Booth in the goal square. He's put on a tight angle, but I'm backing him to kick this. He does, nonchalantly slot it through. Gives a little high 10 to his teammate. Points to Ross. Ross, my hair's better than Gareth Bale Ashman, and says thank you very much. Unfortunately for the French, Lee Tarnes has come back on with 6 goals to his name. He's had a little rest. That's how well they're going, and they're 76-14 at the moment.
And the umpire balls it up in the centre again, and they're moving it forward, the French. They are still determined to get a few more goals. They don't want to let this one get completely out of hand, although some may say it already is completely out of hand. The French crowd are still going wild. They're still cheering on their team. French have never come this close to winning a Euro Cup before. And they get a bad bounce, unfortunately. The English clear it out of defence, and they trickle it over the boundary line. No! French keep it in, but the umpire's blown his whistle. Umpire's giving a free kick to England. Number 4 for England, George Dibble. Was shepherding off the ball. George Dibble drives it into the forward 50. There's a very good mark to number 18, the unknown man from France. He juggles it and controls it over the line. Number 71 for France gets pushed in the back, but the umpire says play on. Sean Walton tries to bust his way through. And he almost does, but the ball trickles over the boundary line. The umpire will throw it in. The scores, 12-4-76 to 2-2-14 at the minute. France get the clearing kick, but it's all England over there. Number 10, again, Matt Whiteley tries to find Sean Walton, but doesn't. And here's Lotelier, definitely France's best player of the day. One of France's best players of the day. Can they get the lucky bounce? No, they cannot. As France shoot for goal and England clean up and take it very silkily out of the back line. But here's the big bustling captain trying to work his way through. Sean Walton grabs it again, appeals to the umpire. The umpire says, "You are pinned," throwing the ball. And now the French look to move it forward again. Big kick into the forward line. Who can they find? There's nobody out there for the French, but lucky for them, it dribbles over the boundary line for a boundary throw in. French crowd cheering their boys on. They want them to get this next goal and try and decrease the margin a little bit. It's definitely not looking good for France. Over 70 points the difference. 60 points the difference, that is. And France have it again, have possession. Can they hold it? Number 10 for France. Martin Mendoza takes it, passes off to number 16. Loic Besnard. He's looking for an option. He's saying, "Come on, guys, give me something." They're not giving him anything. Drives it forward, but gets up and under it. The big man is up there, and takes the mark. Number 88, who is on our team sheet. We call him the big Frenchman. Lining up the goal. He should kick this. He's only about 15 metres out, directly in front. But the English are doing everything they can to make him miss. Unfortunately, he does miss. And the crowd boo. There's 2-3 France now. They're on 15 to 76.
That Bickerdijk has some of the stranger put-off tactics I've ever seen. We've seen the chicken. We just saw the reversing ice cream truck or something. I don't know what that was. I didn't hear the reversing lights, but there was some noise and movement. And the English come forward again. The left foot snap, number 10. Oh, he's taking the mark in the goal square. A certain goal. Whiteley goes back, takes notes. Ooh. Straighten up, he says. You're on a tight angle now. About 60 degrees in the pocket here. One step. Kick, no fast goal. Wow. Whiteley runs off after kicking that goal. Gives a high five. It's celebration time for the English. They've got 6 minutes to cruise on in and celebrate what's been an amazing tournament for them. The French crowd still trying to fire up their local team, their local heroes. Make sure they run this game out and do their country proud, which they have all day, to make this final in the first place.
That's exactly it. The French were definitely underdogs to make it through, and they've made it as far as they have deserved today. They played extremely well all day, and as England bring it into the forward line and kick it behind, the French can reflect on what a good day that they've had, even though they've been blown away a bit in this final match. The French have had a big day defeating teams such as the favourite, Ireland, and the defending champions, Ireland, as well. So the French can be very proud of what they've done today.
That free kick's been paid for the 12 there encroaching on the man kicking in. So you can't get too close to the goal square while they're kicking in, and Shane's paid the free kick, rightly so, to the back edge of the centre square. Advance the ball. Hard lesson learnt, but at this stage England won't mind so much because that error won't make them pay in any sort of way. The young flashy forward number one, Jack Wood, who was exceptional in the semi-final, kicking a burst of goals. He's been quiet today, this game, but he can, you know, the being in the final can be attributed a bit to his performance in the semi, so well done. Lee Tan just runs off the bench, says, I wouldn't mind a seventh, but handballs, that could be first handball for the day for Lee Tan. He's more of a kicker than a handballer. And he's asking Kilheeny, I am dead set 20 metres out in front, just kick it to me. Killer says, no, I'll have a shot myself. Kilheeny strolls in, kicks long, kicks strong, misses to the left for behind. What have we got now, scorer? We've got 13 goals, 7, 85, versus 2 goals, 3, 18. This one's certainly in the bag for the English, and they'll be over the moon. They had the disappointment, the GB Bulldogs losing in the final by a point with the last kick of the game to the Irish. This will certainly go away to atoning that and erasing that from the memory from a month ago. Many of the same players that were in the GB team are here today. Oh boy, we've got a streaker. Oh no! He's not young either. Oh boy! Put it away. What are those jocks? Have you, and the English. No worries about the distraction. The umpire has said, tell your story walking. Go and get off the ground. I mean, the football's the focus. He's tried the belly slide, but it was more of a belly plug. I think he's been drinking Bordeaux wine, I'm not sure. Thank goodness he's pulled his undies back up as he moves back towards the crowd. Here comes security. I hope someone's got his picture for future reference of what not to do.
And after that excitement, we turn back to the football, where England just got one more goal and they extend their lead even further. They're on 91-15. This is just a complete whitewash. The streaker has since been detained. I think he's gone to get some more wine.
Great finish there to the game. The English celebrate, the French crowd appreciate the great day of football they've seen at the Axios Euro Cup. What a great day of football. We hope you've enjoyed the telecast here, the streaming throughout the day. We'd love to get your feedback on how the day's gone, and we'll shortly have the presentation to the top three teams who have finished: Croatia, France and England. The score finishes 92-15. England run out convincing winners in their Axios Euro Cup win.